हे गाइस, वेलकम बैक टू स्प्रिंट व्हील्स अगैन। एंड आज हम बात करेंगे एक नई लॉन्च जो कि मर्सिडीज बेंज करने वाली है, अपने प्रोडक्ट को लॉन्च करने वाली है इंडिया में। एंड जो नई व्हीकल मर्सिडीज बेंज लॉन्च करने वाली है इंडिया में, उसका नाम है मर्सिडीज बेंज GLS। सो विदाउट एनी फर्दर डू, लेट्स बिगिन। सो बेसिकली रिसेंटली मर्सिडीज बेंज के CEO मार्टिन स्क्वेंक जो हैं, उन्होंने रिसेंटली अपने सोशल मीडिया हैंडल्स पे अनाउंस किया था कि दे विल बी लॉन्चिंग दिस न्यू ब्रांड न्यू मॉडल ऑफ द मर्सिडीज बेंज GLS इन इंडिया ऑन June 17th। सो बेसिकली मर्सिडीज बेंज GLS, अगर आप लोगों को अगर नहीं पता इसके बारे में, तो मैं आपको बता देता हूँ कि मर्सिडीज बेंज GLS मर्सिडीज की सबसे लंबी और सबसे बड़ी SUV रही है अपनी सेगमेंट में, एंड इट सिट्स ऑन द टॉप ऑफ इट्स SUV लाइनअप इन इंडिया। सो नाउ दिस SUV माइट बी द बिगेस्ट and the largest SUV by the Mercedes-Benz in India. And you might be wondering that the sales number of this SUV is low, but that's not true. It's the one of the most likable SUV from the Mercedes-Benz lineup of the cars or lineup of SUVs in India. And people buy this SUV just for the way it looks, its road presence, its space, complete package of luxury, space and those off-roading skills as well. नाउ अगर हम इतनी स्पेस की बात कर रहे हैं कि दिस SUV इज़ वेरी बिग, इसके अंदर बहुत ज़्यादा स्पेस है, बहुत ज़्यादा लंबी SUV है, बहुत बड़ी SUV है, तो एग्जैक्टली कितना डायमेंशंस क्या है इस SUV की, तो मैं आपको बता दूं कि ये SUV पूरे 5 meters लॉन्ग है। जी हाँ, पूरे 5 meters लॉन्ग है, और इसके अंदर आपको ढेर सारा लेग रूम मिलता है, ढेर सारा हेड रूम मिलता है, इवन इन द थर्ड रो ऑफ द कार, वेयर आप जो भी 7-seater SUVs को देखते हैं या फिर 8-seater SUVs को देखते हैं इंडिया के अंदर, उनमें सिर्फ और सिर्फ एक ड्रॉबैक होता है कि उसके अंदर स्पेस नहीं होता है थर्ड रो के अंदर। तो बंदा थर्ड रो के अंदर बैठता है, ही डज नॉट फील कंफर्टेबल एट ऑल, बिकॉज वहाँ पे आप बैठ के यू फील वेरी क्रैम्प्ड अप एंड नो यू कैन नॉट एन्जॉय लॉन्ग जर्नीज सिटिंग इन द थर्ड रो ऑफ द कार। बट in that case only you need humongous SUVs, like big SUVs like the Mercedes Benz, and as huge, as big as this SUV is, as full size as this SUV is, it's as easy to drive and as easy to maneuver around in the city as well as on the highways. If you look at the Mercedes Benz GLS on the first instance and you have a first look towards that car, you'll find that it has a very upright and a very intimidating character. You know, when you see it, you will just feel like, yeah, it's a big car. You'll feel like that, yeah, it's a very big car and it's humongous, it's upright from every corner. And the new Mercedes-Benz GLS will now be having all the latest Mercedes-Benz features that the other Mercedes-Benz, other siblings of this car will be having. It will be better equipped than the last generation of the Mercedes-Benz GLS, and whether it's the tech, whether it's the seat comfort, whether it's the leather upholstery, whether it's at the smallest details around the car, whether it's the interior design, the dash design, the controls, steering now comes with the touch control that we have seen in the latest launches done by the Mercedes, and the upcoming S-Class that will be launched in 2021, we'll be making another video upon that. So that S-Class will also be having those steering mounted audio controls and all other cruise control as well, but those controls will not be buttons, will not be traditional buttons, they will be touch controls, and the touch controls will be having some vibratic or haptic feature, so that whenever you touch those controls, you will get some response from the system and you will be instantly knowing that, yeah, I've pressed that control and that function has started working. The car now gets the two new humongous screens or humongous displays inside the car. One is for the display of your instrument cluster and the other one is for the display of your infotainment system. Now the good thing is that both these displays will be having 12.3 inch as dimensions, and they will be very, very huge and very informative to whatsoever is happening in your car. You will be able to navigate through the display on the instrument cluster of the car. You will be able to see the dials, you will be able to see how your car performs, different driving modes as well. So that's what your display is gonna tell you, एंड द 12.3 इंच टच स्क्रीन इंफोटेनमेंट सिस्टम और द इंफोटेनमेंट डिस्प्ले दैट द कार विल बी हैविंग विल बी इक्विप्ड विद द मर्सिडीज बेंज एमबैक्स टच स्क्रीन इंफोटेनमेंट टेक्नोलॉजी एंड ओवरऑल द इंटीरियर्स ऑफ द कार विल बी मिनिमलिस्टिक. Before, if you would have seen that the previous generations of the Mercedes-Benz that were launched in the previous generation was having a lot of buttons. Though it was a modernized car, it was having a lot of new tech going around, a lot of new displays going around, but still it had buttons. But now the center console and the most of the functions will be having those touch related haptic buttons, and it will be a very minimalistic experience when you sit in the cabin of the car. And that's what makes it special. Talking about the suspension, it now gets the new AS suspension in the car, which gives it a very smooth and comfortable ride, you know, in the rough sections of the road, or even if you are driving in the potholes. And what adds to the comfort of the ride is the humongous alloy wheels that are equipped in this car. So that will be easily, so your car will easily glide over those small potholes or bumps on the road. As we all know about the Indian roads, so it will be a very comfortable ride, and even on the rough sections of the road as well. Then talking about the engine and the transmission of the car, the new Mercedes-Benz GLS will be getting a 3-liter turbocharged petrol engine, which will be generating 364 horses with 500 newton meters of torque. And apart from that, it will also get a diesel option. Though many car manufacturers have been eliminating their diesel model during the BS6 launch in India, the major car manufacturer like Maruti Suzuki and many other car manufacturers have eliminated the diesel models from some of their models of the car completely. But the Mercedes-Benz GLS will be getting a diesel option as well. It will be getting a 3-liter diesel engine that would produce 286 horses at massive 600 newton meters of torque, which is a good news for the diesel lovers. And the model that sells in India for the GLS, for the Mercedes-Benz GLS in India, is the diesel one. Talking about the transmission, it will be getting a 9-speed automatic transmission with the Merc's all-wheel drive system. Now you might be wondering that all this luxury and comfort and technology might come at a price with it in India. And yes, it comes at a whopping 1 crores in India and will go up against the likes of the BMW's full-size SUV in India, that is the BMW's X7. So if you like this video, then hit a big fat thumbs up and subscribe to the Sprintfields YouTube channel, because I'll be back with such amazing videos of the new cars and launches and the cars that would be spotted around in India. So be ready for that and subscribe and stay tuned with the Sprintfields YouTube channel. Until then, stay home, stay safe, and drive safe. I'll be back.